Good evening, everyone. This is Breakthrough Prayer. It is a pleasure and an honor to just to welcome you all into our home, the home of Bishop Holtz and myself, Prophetess. I just want y'all to know that we love you all and so excited to be with you all tonight on this Tuesday night live Bible study, walking in the Word. Amen. God is so awesome. He is just so good. And this is the day that He has made, and let us just all rejoice and be glad in this day. I just hope all of you all are well and healthy and safe. We're praying for you. And I know as we pray for you, you pray for us, because we need your prayers. The prayers of the righteous availeth much. Like I always say, much prayer, much power, little prayer, little power. And if you ain't got no prayer life, you ain't got no power. So we all got to get prayed up and stayed up in the Word of God. So Bishop, Bishop, and join us on tonight on this Breakthrough Prayer. Amen. God bless you and God keep you is our prayer. Amen. We love you all. God, just have your way tonight. We just want to pray. Father, we ask you right now to move by your Spirit and by your power. God, we ask you to let your people, God, out there, incline the ear to hear what you are saying. God, we just thank you for this day, God. And we praise you for this day, God. There is none like you, God. You are great and you are greatly to be praised, God. We pour our hearts to you, God. We pour our souls to you. And God, we just ask you to have your way in our life, God. We go move out the way, God, so you can get in the way and have your perfect way tonight. We just thank you in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So, you know, tonight we're just so excited and we just want to talk to you a little bit tonight about how to ask God in prayer, how to ask God. Do you know how to talk to God in prayer and to ask him for what you want? Because we got to know how to ask God for what we want, just like we ask our mothers and our fathers for what we want. We got to know how to ask him in prayer. So we want to talk to you, how do you ask God in prayer? You got to ask him, first of all, with simplicity. You got to have, you know, simplicity, come before him, just simple. And then you got to ask him, you got to seek him with intensity, and you got to knock with persistency. So how to ask God in prayer? The Bible says in Matthew 7:7, he says, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. So we know we got the ask. And it will be given. You got to seek and you will find it. And then you got to knock and it shall be open to you. What does that mean? In other words, we told you had to ask with a simplicity. And what does simplicity mean? When I asked, I looked that up and I Googled that. And it says, Google says simplicity is the state or the quality of being simple. You ain't got to go to them with no big words. Just be simple, humble. Something which is easily to understand or explain. Seems simple in contrast to something complicated. We ain't got to go to God trying to, you know how some people you want to impress, you in the courtroom or you want to be around some people who got degrees and they use big words and you trying to use words. Well, we ain't got to talk to God like that. All we got to do is just come to him humble and just talk to him from our hearts. Amen. You ain't got to have a PhD. All you got to do is just come and be born again. And even if you're not born again, but if you come to him and you just talk to him, God will open up his heart. He'll let you come in. So that's what we got to do. We got to ask, because you know what? When you ask, you always get a response. Think of a gift. Like sometimes when your children come and they ask you, Mom, Dad, can I have this or can I have that? And when they ask you, and if they come in the right way and they know how to use their eyes and they can look at you in a certain way, whatever they're asking you for, they end up most a good parent or a good mother or a good father, they receive what they're asking for. And that's the way God wants us. When we come to him, and we just pour out our hearts to him, and we genuine in our spirit, and when we ask him, and we pant for him, and when we go after him, God will give us what we want when we are sincere in our heart, and we're diligent in our heart, and we walk upright. Amen. So that's why we just want you to ask him. Ask, it says, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened. You got to ask with simplicity. Asking, when you ask God for something, you're always going to get a response. You're always going to get a response. He's always going to give you a response if you're diligent in your pursuit to God. We are God's children. He wants us to ask like a little child. Just ask him like a little child. Like people are like, how do you talk to God? Just come to him simple like little children. And we got to have faith when we are asked. And then when you ask him, you know, when you go to, I know when my kids used to come to me, or even when they still come, they ain't asking for no little bitty thing. They ask large. We sell a big God. We serve a big God. So you can come to God and ask him for something big. Amen. Because we ought to keep on asking. Keep asking. Like sometimes my kid, they go keep on asking. They go keep on, like, get on your nerves. And they go keep on asking. They ain't going to stop. Some do not ask. Many of us don't ask. But you should ask. Do it continually and ask. That's what Matthew 7 and 8 says. It says ask. When we ask God, you got to be specific for what you want or need. Ask him to provide that for you, what you're asking. God will always come through. You got to be specific about your request. You know, what am I asking for? What are you requesting for? Be specific. Tell God exactly what you want or what you need. He wants you to ask him for it. You got to be specific. Ask for it. You know, like if somebody got something or they borrowed something and you want what you, they borrowed from, you go right back and say, listen, you got this from me and I'm asking you to give it back. That's what God wants us to say to him. Ask him specifically for what we want, what we desire. God can answer vague prayers, but being specific creates a deeper bond between you and him. So we got to be specific when we ask him. And that's creating a bond, a closeness with you. You know, when you with somebody, the more time you spend with them, or you talk to them, the closer you feel, the closer I get to you. And the closer, you remember that song? It was a song, the closer I get to you, the more you make me feel. The more we get close to God, the more he makes us feel so special. So that's all God wants you to just to come to him humble and just ask him, because he's our Heavenly Father. And he just ready to just to pour out to you and to answer your prayer requests. Amen. So just that's the first one. How do we come simple before him? You just got to be simple. You ain't got to be all puffed up, all big, you know, like you just trying to impress someone. We don't have to impress God. We just be humble. And then the next one is to seek him. Seek him with intensity. Seek him with intensity. Seek, and the Bible tells us to seek and you shall find. To seek him with intensity means we got to seek his face. Got to be face to face with him. To be in his presence. In the presence is the fullness of joy. Having access to God. We have access, especially when we spend quality time with him. You have access with him. You can talk to him about anything. Just to be in his presence, it's soothing. It feels so good. Because when you're in his presence, when you seek him, you're going to find him. The Bible says seeking brings discovery. We discover God's word, his promises, and his blessings. Deuteronomy 4:29 says, but if you seek him, see, that's prerequisite. If you seek him, because many don't want to seek him. If you seek something, you ever kept looking for something, you keep looking, you're looking for something, you're going to end up finding it. So seek ye first, seek him, and if you seek him, you're going to find him. And you got to search for him. And when you seek him, you search for him, you want to get deeper. And when you get deeper with God, you feel rich in him. You got rich values. to be found in Christ. There's so much in Christ, things to be found that we don't know about him. Because the more you spend quality time with him, the more he began to reveal those hidden parts of him. The parts we never, there's treasures. You begin to discover treasures in God. Treasures are discovered in the secret place of the Most High. And that's in the book of Psalms 91:1. Precious souls you find in God. There are souls in God for more valuable than silver and gold. When you seek him, his glory is more precious than silver and gold. And you know, people who have silver and gold, they value it because it's real valuable. But when you got God, it's more precious than silver and gold. And with Christ, you can do anything. So we got to seek him. Seek him while he might be found. Because it come a day, like sometimes you look, you ever been looking for somebody and you couldn't find them? Well, if you don't seek the Lord while you can, while the health is in your body and while you got your right mind, you know, and it come a time, your mind going, you can't seek him. You won't be able to find him. But if you seek him while you in your right mind, you can find him. You don't want to seek him. You done lost your mind. So seek him while he might be found. You can find him when you're in your right mind. So seek God early while he might be found. Seek him early in the morning. Put him first. And if you put God first, he'll put you first. Come on, y'all, give God some praise and some glory. I love seeking the Lord. I've been seeking him. I seek God with intensity. I seek him. It's a priority. It's a daily passion. And you got to be diligent when you seek him. Here is how you can seek God. You can read your Bible. God speaks through his word. His written word to those whose hearts are longing for him, aching for him. I desire him. I thirst for him. I pant for him like a deer panting for the water. How do you seek God? You can just begin to sing songs. No. You don't have to be a Yolanda Adams. You don't have to be, you know, a great singer. But you can just sing out of your heart, out of your soul. And God hear your heart. Because he know that you're diligent. You mean it. You intense. It's an intensity. Lord, I got to have you. God, I desire to spend quality time with you. I want it. You know, when you intensify, I got to be there. I want to be in your presence, God. It's a priority, God. It's my passion, dear God, to be in your presence. Glory. You got to spend quality time with him every day. Do you spend quality time with him every day? Do you read your Bible every day? Do you pray every day? Do you seek his face every single day? Do you have a relationship with him, a one-on-one relationship? Because sometimes we spend more time with the things of the world than we do the ways of God. And we must seek him early while he might be found. Early, like they say, the early birds, they catch the worm. They get the job. Seek him while he might be found. Don't come trying to seek the Lord late at night when you done did everything. All through the day, you done went about and done all your everything, and you didn't even put God first. Now you fatigued, now you tired, and you worn out. And God don't want that. He want the best, because he gave his best, his only begotten son, Jesus, that we may have life, and not just life, but more abundantly. So if God gave his best, we ought to give him his best. Amen. And then, my last one is this. How do you ask God in prayer? You got to knock. Knock with persistency. You ever been persistent about something? It's a knock, and it shall be opened unto you. Like when I know my kid, they're going to knock. They're going to keep on, mom, dad. They don't stop. They keep pulling on you. They keep knocking. They keep asking. Knock, 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 knock. You get tired. Like, I hear you until you just give up. What you want? And that's the way we got to do. Not with persistency. I'm not going to stop, Lord, till you answer me. God, I'm not going to stop, God, till I get what I'm asking you for, God. I'm knocking at the door. I stand at the door and I knock. And God, if he knock, he said, I'm going to open up. And I'm going to have a relationship with you. He want a relationship with you. But you got to be persistent. Knocking and she'll be open unto you. Persistent knocking gets a response. You want a response from God? Then knock. Persistent knockers mean prevailing. Prayer, fasting. Sometimes we got to do it all night. All night prayer brings breakthrough. Persistent prayer gains an entrance into the secret treasures of the divine resources of God. I mean, when you're persistent, you get an interest. It's a door open for you. God opened up the door and he just began to feed you, talk to you, commune you, pour out to you, speak to your spirit, speak to your soul. So don't stop knocking. Don't think you'll never get on his nerve. In fact, he want you to be in his presence. He want you to come before him. He wants you to keep stay with him. If you stay with God, the enemy, he gonna let you know what the enemy is trying to do. He will show you the adversary with his tricks and all his schemes and all his plots. Amen. Persistent knocking calls determination. You got to be determined. God, I'm determined, God. I'm not going to stop, God, till you bless me. I'm not going to stop, God, till you open up the door. God, I'm not going to stop, open, God, till I get my breakthrough. God, I'm not going to stop, God, till my child, God, they begin to do, God, what I say do, God. I'm not going to stop, God. I need you till, God, you heal my marriage, dear God. I'm not going to stop, dear God, till you heal my body. God, I'm not going to stop, God. Lord, I'm knocking, God. God, you be my judge in the courtroom. I got to go, God, before you. My child got to go before you. I need you to plead their case, dear God. God, oh, God, I thank you. And the more we spend time for him, God, hallelujah, he grows on us. You know, like an oak tree, it gets grow on you. Like a rose. And you know how rose, a lot of women, they love rose. It takes time for God to grow on an oak tree and on a rose. So it takes time. Like you want it the first time. No, you got to keep being persistent. You got to keep being persistent. Don't you stop. If he ain't answer, he may not come when you want him. But he'll be on time. Somebody say he's an on-time God. Yes, he is. I know he's an on-time God. Yes, he is. Mother, he's been an on-time God for you. He's been an on-time God for you, Father. He's an on-time God. Yes, he is. I know he is. My grandmama told me he was an on-time God. My mother told me he was an on-time God. And I remember my great-grandmother, she told he's an on-time God. Yes, he is. And I know he's always been on time for me. He's never late. He may not come when you want him, but he'll be there on time. It takes some time to answer certain prayers of ours. So don't you be in a hurry. He may not come when you want him, but he'll be there on time. Oh, God is just so good. He is so awesome. And then we say, how do you ask God in prayer? You ask him with simplicity. You seek him with intensity, and you knock with persistency. Are y'all ready to do all three? Then if you're ready to do all three, God will do just what you ask. Because God say, if you all know how to give your children good gifts, how much more do you think your heavenly Father going to give you? Good God Almighty. If you know how to give good, and you know we know how to give some good things, but we can't outdo God. God created the gifts that we give to our children. We ought to keep asking him. Just keep on. And God will bless you beyond what you can even ask or think. Just stay in his presence. God is so awesome. And I just thank God for this word. I'm not going to be as long as Bishop, but it's a fact that God is an on-time God. It's a fact. I love him. I thank him. It's short because y'all know Bishop got long lines, and I'm just kind of, you know, right there to the point. So just thank y'all tonight. God bless you. I want my bishop to come on in. And I just thank you all. How to ask God in prayer. we got to get in prayer during this pandemic, because some things don't come but by fasting and by prayer. And we got to pray much for our land, pray much for our neighbors, pray much for our president, pray much for those who are going the wrong direction. Let's just pray. I love y'all, New Hope. Acts, and it shall be given.
You did an awesome job, prophetess. I am so proud of you. I have been blessed tonight by this word.
Thank you.
I am so proud of you. Mwah. Yes. Give me those 3 points again. You got to be what?
I say you got to ask with simplicity.
All right.
You got to seek with intensity.
All right.
And you got to knock with persistency.
My goodness. Make it simple.
You make it simple.
Be persistent.
Be persistent.
And what else?
And I say with intensity.
With intensity.
Yeah.
Got to turn up the heat of prayer.
Yeah, got to turn it up. You know, you can't cook nothing trying to, cook a meal and you ain't got no heat.
Yeah. Got to turn the heat up.
Yeah, you got to put the fire. Put some fire to it. Some fire in your prayers.
You know what else I discovered tonight as you was teaching this word? And it's an excellent word on prayer. Don't miss this, saints. But as you were saying that prayer grows on you like an oak tree, mm-hmm. It grows on you. Mm-hmm. Prayer also have a scent.
Oh my God.
There is an odor, there's an aroma that goes with prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And the more you pray and the more you get in God's face, it's a sweet smelling aroma that goes up to God.
You know what, Bishop?
Yes.
That is so true. And I'm just saying persistency, because if you believe what you're praying for lines up with the will of God,
yeah,
then you must also believe that God wants you to be, you to have it.
Yeah.
God also wants you to be persistent and asking. In the scripture in Luke, Jesus is telling his disciples that they need to pray a certain way through persistency.
See, that's the aroma.
And then.
That's the aroma. That's the odor.
Yeah.
And that's the scent of prayer. You can tell people who pray.
Yeah.
There's a certain aroma.
Yeah.
There's a certain scent that God is pleased with.
Yeah.
You know, it's like when I get close to you, I love your perfume. You know, it smells good. There's a certain scent that I love when I'm around you. So prayer gives that odor, that scent up to God. And it's a sweet smelling aroma that goes up.
Yeah.
And when God senses it,
yeah,
He sends it.
Oh my God, yeah. I like that, Bishop.
Like that?
Yeah.
When God sends it, He sends it.
My God.
He sends back your healing, your miracle, and everything that you need. Yes, go ahead, baby.
But anyway, I just want to say this little, and when you want to just ask God something or know how, all you got to say, Dear Lord,
mm-hmm.
I come to you now.
Go ahead.
In need of your wisdom
and
direction. I bring you this situation.
Come on.
This is what I'm going through.
Yeah.
Then I want you to name that situation. I want you to describe that situation.
Yeah.
Then you say, I open my hands and heart to hear from you.
My hands and my heart.
To hear from you, oh Lord. That's all you got to say. Do you hear me, Bishop?
Let us go boldly.
Before his throne.
Before the throne of grace.
In time.
That we may find help
in the time of our need.
And we need something from God right about now. So whatever your need is and whatever your request may be, believe that you can get it through prayer. Your Father, your Heavenly Father, is waiting to hear from you.
My God.
And all you got to do is be simple in your prayer, turn up the intensity of prayer, and be persistent. Keep on knocking. Ask, and you shall receive.
Yes.
Seek.
And you shall find,
knock, and the door shall be open to you.
Yes.
Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, God, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for the rhema of this word. We thank you for the simplicity of this word. We thank you for reminding us that we need to intensify our need to pray. That we need to pray more often. You said in your word that man should always pray lest we faint. You told us in your word that the prayers of the righteous availeth much.
Yes.
And you told us, God, to be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication
yes,
and
Father.
Thanksgiving, make our requests known to you. We know, God, that you are waiting on your throne to hear from us.
Yes, Lord.
And you are there, God, receiving the sweet aroma of prayer from us. And God, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
God, someone right now in our living rooms need a blessing. Our children, our spouse, our family, our friends, and even our enemies.
Yes.
Certainly our community and our country.
Thank you, Lord.
Needs delivering and healing. And God, we need your protection.
Yes, Father.
Right now in the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
So God, we thank you.
Thank you, Father.
For all that you are doing.
Oh, yes, Lord.
And for what you are doing
now.
Oh,
God, we thank you.
And for what you're going to do.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus'
name. In the name of Jesus.
Tonight, you can be saved.
Yes.
You can be delivered.
Yes.
And you can be healed.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, prophetess.
Thank you.
Thank you again.
Thank you.
Our New Hope family.
Amen.
And our friends, thank you so much for joining us. I am so proud of my wife tonight. She did an excellent job. And she is really more long-winded than I am. Don't let that fool you. She can go. But she did an excellent job tonight. And we're not going to forget the words you've given us tonight.
Thank you.
God bless you.
God bless you, New Hope.
And we'll see you in the morning.
We love you all.
At 6 a.m. for our breakthrough prayer. It's Wednesday now, hump day. So tomorrow morning, 6 a.m., join us in our breakthrough prayer.
Breakthrough.
As we make our request simple, as we intensify prayer and be persistent in our request.
Yes.
God bless you, saints. And we love you.
Amen. Jesus. Yes. Yes.